non-communicable, epidemic, preventable diseases of undernutrition, cancer, cardiovascular disease, stroke, diabetes, and obesity. These five non-communicable, preventable diseases of undernutrition are the five top money makers of the pharmaceutical and illness industry, and they are also what will result, according to their to the WHO and FAO predictions, when Codex mandates undernutrition on a global basis.
One of the things that struck me as frightening as I watch television, which I'm paying attention more and more to the advertisements, I usually turn it off, but I've never seen so many pharmaceutical ads in my life. It is full-scale hypnosis.
Absolutely. And they're very beautifully constructed and carefully paced, and the prattle about all the side effects that runs across the bottom.
It's like comedy.
It is. It is indeed like comedy. It is actually presented at a frequency range and a pacing rhythm that prevents you from remembering any of it.
But it's somewhere.
I actually testified at FDA hearings on precisely this subject, on the direct-to-consumer advertising of pharmaceuticals. And the testimony was presented that made it very clear that this was very, very carefully crafted. And the representatives of the pharmaceutical industry acknowledged that this part of the ad was designed to be unretrievable.
You know what? There's an actual science, a neuroscience that's used in advertising. I'm doing a special piece on it that actually bypasses the conscious brain.
Correct.
And
Correct.
Implants the content into the subconscious in such a way as to get it to make the buying decision.
Exactly.
Is that frightening or what?
Neuromarketing. Well, you know, you are more susceptible to this when you have fluoride in your body. Fluoride is a substance which is a known neurotoxin and endocrine poison. It does, in fact, not protect your teeth or your bones. It leads to damage to your teeth and bones. And it was used first by Joseph Stalin to control the political prisoners in his gulags, and then the Nazis learned about it and used it in the concentration camps and the slave labor camps. And then toward the end of the war, when the German people became aware that they weren't winning this war, that they were supposed to win so easily, the whole population was fluoridated. Why? Because it makes people complacent. You can do anything you want with them. Then the fluoridation scientists, among many, many other scientists, were brought to the United States, and in totally bogus studies in Newburgh, New York, and Salt Lake City, it was found that the children who were experimented upon, children experimented upon? That sounds rather Nazified, doesn't it? The children who were experimented upon actually had more cancer, more tooth decay, more bone breaks, more diabetes than the children who didn't receive fluoride, and yet the findings were published with the headings switched. About 6 years ago, the FDA reviewed the documents again, the original research, and acknowledged in writing that the headings had been switched, so the conclusions were completely wrong, but continued to support fluoridation of all water supplies. In Europe, this past March, the European Union ended the practice of fluoridating water because the health problems are so serious. But we have it sprayed on our food, we have it in our water supplies, and frighteningly, we have the Codex nutrient reference values, which are the levels to which people are supposed to have their nutrients go, but no higher, and they're shamefully inadequate, except for fluoride, which can be taken in at 4 milligrams per day. This is an incredibly toxic dose. Everything else is so low as to have no effect on any human being by intention. stated in the Codex documents. But fluoride, that's a different story. So part of the reason that people are able to be controlled by neuromarketing is because their neurological systems are damaged by fluoride, by accident.
Doctor, the fluoride is in most of the toothpaste still. Even in the health food stores, there's still a lot of fluoridated toothpaste.
Yes, there is.
And it's in the water when we wash our food. California was mandated years ago. They had to put fluoride in the water. The Dental Association lobbied for it being in the water. Why?
The Dental Association has been propagandized and misled the same way the medical associations have been. Doctors are actually duped into thinking, and I survived medical school. I know that it's a brainwashing cult activity, and it's designed through emotional intimidation, sleep deprivation, protein deprivation, and a hierarchical structure of abuse to get people to buy into the system mindlessly and abuse those coming up below them to inculcate them into the system. But, and the Dental Association is no different, but the fact is that we can protect ourselves. There are filters that will take out most of the fluoride. We can also make sure that we read labels very carefully, and it's not always easy. When we were last in the United States, we ran out of toothpaste. We went to a large health food store, and the word fluoride was buried so deeply in the label that although it said natural, natural, organic, organic, when I got it back to the hotel, I saw that it had fluoride in it, and I threw it out. So you have to be vigilant, and you have to make sure that you're protecting yourself from fluoride. And by the way, many psychiatric drugs are primarily fluoride.
What does that mean? They're coated with fluoride, or that's...
No, that the compound that causes calming, let's say, in agitation, or masks the symptoms of depression by taking away the vitality of people's emotions, these are all fluoride compounds. Not all. These are many of them, fluoride compounds. And so they poison the brain on a long-term basis. And oh, by the way, the longest-term studies for psychiatric drugs in children are 13 weeks.
What does that mean? It's short, correct?
It means that you give something to a kid on an experimental basis for 13 weeks, and then you keep the kid on that substance for the rest of their lives without any knowledge of what it does to their developing brain structure or to their endocrine system or to the neurotransmitters are found everywhere in the body. One of the reasons that people who take antidepressants, serotonin reuptake inhibitors or SSRIs, get osteoporosis, including children, is that Mother Nature is very conservative, and so the same enzymes that process serotonin in the brain are present at the surface of the brain, of the bone and in the gut and elsewhere. And so when you poison those enzyme systems, you get changes in every part of the body. None of that's ever been studied properly. These things are, the drugs are tremendously toxic. Nutrients and herbs are not toxic in the same way. And it's almost impossible to kill yourself with vitamin C, for instance, but they're the principal economic competitors of drugs. And food is another principal economic competitor of drugs because healthy people don't need drugs. Healthy people eat healthy food. Poison the food, keep the market going, depopulate the planet. Real simple.
I think for a lot of people, if they could go all the way through what you're all saying, right up to the depopulate the planet part. Just because the average person could...
A famous memo written by Henry Kissinger in 1972 to Richard Nixon, in which he said that population reduction has to be the central element in U.S. foreign policy. This has been around for a while.
Right. No, I know it's been around for a while. I'm more speaking from the audience perception.
Here's my response, Kim.
Yeah.
At that point, when people say, well, I buy everything you've said, but no, the depopulation part can't be true, which of course is an emotional response, not a rational one, but
exactly.
We're all entitled to our emotions.
Sure.
I say, okay, skip that part.